nacho night. Nicotine breakfast just to put me right. Cause if you want to, if you want to, if you want to, you got to run. Only if you want, if you want to, if you want to,
crazy on the wall. Like it always did, like the Spanish city too. When I
across Australia and New Zealand. Tonight's concert at the Sydney Entertainment Centre is certainly going to be a major event. It is the final concert of an extraordinary world tour by one of the world's hottest bands, Dire Straits. Over the past 12 months, they have toured 25 countries and have performed to an amazing 260 sell-out concerts. In Australia and New Zealand alone, they have performed to over 1 million people. Tonight, through the faculty for the facilities of the Nine Network in Australia and on TV One Network throughout New Zealand, millions more will be able to witness this brilliant, and I mean brilliant, band in concert in a live to-air link-up on over 150 stations. The music of Dire Straits covers all ages from 6 to 60, and since the release of their first album in 1978, which was simply titled Dire Straits, their music has been heard on almost every radio station in the Western world, and even, I might add, in many radio stations in the Eastern Bloc and the Third World countries. Their smash hit, Sultans of Swing, made them a household name worldwide. Since then, they have produced 5 albums. Their latest, Brothers in Arms, which was released about a year ago, shot to number 1 nationally the first week of release on the Australian album charts. It has remained there and remained for about 32 weeks, and that's the longest any album has ever stayed on the number 1 position in the history of Australia's charts. Brothers in Arms has sold worldwide over 12 million copies, and believe me, that is some feat. Dire Straits is a class band with some of the best musicians in the world, and their influence is covering a broad spectrum of music from contemporary rock to classical. So to all of you Australians and New Zealanders, again welcome. And let me remind you, after this concert and during this concert is a simulcast wherever possible through your local FM or AM stereo station. And I strongly suggest that you do yourself a favour and tune in, turn up with this great musical experience. Right now I'm leaving to go backstage to talk to Mark Knopfler just prior to introducing this fantastic band live in concert for their final performance of the world tour. It's going to be a Dire Straits concert tonight that you've never seen before. We'll be right back after this commercial break. We'll see you then. A very nervous intro. I'm now in the dressing rooms of Dire Straits and it gives me great pleasure to introduce Mark Knopfler. Mark, welcome to tonight. Who's the joker sitting next to you, incidentally?
I don't know.
I've seen him hanging around the stable for so long. Excuse me?
No.
Ed, the manager of Dire Straits.
Hello.
Had to get him first.
That's who you are.
That's who
you
are.
Hello. Nice to meet you at last.
All right, now listen, down to the serious side. How do you and the band feel?
We're such jokers.
Now, how do you feel that it's the sort of the last concert of this world tour? It's really come to an end.
Well, I think it's mixed feelings all around. You know, the road crew have been coming in like old retainers, you know, leaving, but they've been with you for a long time. It's like, it's very weird, because, I mean, everybody, you're very conscious of the fact there's a lot of guys that have been putting all their talents and their abilities together to make something work for everybody, and they've done a really great job for us, for the band.
Well,
they're
not.
But as
I said, it's spanned 25 countries in the last year and 260 concerts. When you first put this tour together and thinking of doing a world tour, did you imagine it to be this big?
No.
And to go for so long?
No. I think it was originally about 6 months. Right. And it just grew.
I mean, like when you were telling me just before you were coming out here in LA, you said I've planned 6 or 7 concerts at the Entertainment Centre in Sydney. It turned out to be 20. Yeah. I think it was about 7 in Melbourne. It turned out to be, 13?
13, yeah.
It just seemed to go on and on. Yeah. I mean, did ever get to a stage, just even in this part of the Australasian tour in New Zealand and Australia, that there'd be another day and you'd think, my God, I've got to go and play again tonight. Did the band yourselves ever feel jaded stuff?
Yeah, I think if you're doing a long stretch in one place, like 20 nights here in Sydney, you know, you get the feeling that you should have a clocking in machine, you should just be coming after a while.
Right.
And you have to do certain things to try and break the monotony. And we've managed to do that all right, I think. And I think the band's been playing better all the time as well, which is very surprising all around, that the standards have been kept, been able to maintain standards all the way through and find new things in the music all the time. The other thing is that I'm very proud of the band and the crew for getting the whole thing sorted out, is the fact that there's a lot of fans there that come and see the band who aren't necessarily a rock and roll. The fans that would be used to having just a seething mass of real rock and roll fans in there. There's a lot of other people coming in that, I mean, for one of them, we kind of call them the tour. we'll see what all the fuss is about. And it's nice to turn them on, to turn them around during the course of a night.
Well, also with the bands, I mean, a lot of bands have a sound like after spinning it.
That it becomes a strain on the band because the members are seeing each other every day. I mean, has there ever been any sort of strain on this band? Yeah, we're very hot on the fact that your feet haven't got to smell on the
après
bus.
Kilomètre 700.
You know, that you keep your... what do you make of
it? Yourself.
It's kind of like a marriage, I guess, in a way.
You know, funny, just before you came in, I was saying that there hasn't been a single fight or even major disagreement between anybody within the crew or within the band.
Right, now, I want to ask you this, I'll ask Ed. Normally the band don't like doing television, and now you're doing like an entire live performance. Mm-hmm. What motivated you to do that?
Well, one of the reasons it's live, because television isn't live. And I think that, you know, that process of... You know, the pop TV show where you're miming is boring. But it's nice to be able to thank the people in Australia and New Zealand, for the tour, you know. Yeah. It's really that, and it's also for the drug offence campaign.
Right, like, one criticism, if there's been any criticism of the show, and it's a criticism that was also levelled at the Sting show, is that both you and Sting don't talk that much on stage. What's your thoughts on that? Do you know, I haven't really thought that much about it. Sometimes I've been known to. I haven't really thought. But whereas other people say, why should they talk on stage? The music speaks for itself. Well, you said it. I love it. Yeah.
So it's a question of performance style, I think.
All right. The thing is, you want the thing to flow, but you don't want to keep breaking it up with or too much of this.
Well, listen, I've got 12,000 people out there ready to flow. Concert, because some of this money of tonight is going to a great cause.
All of it.
All of it is going to such a great cause. Whose idea was that? Collectively, the band.
Yes. I mean, we were made aware when we came to Australia about the drug problem here, and the fact that this campaign was about to start. And it's seen, I mean, Australia's given, and New Zealand have given a lot to us. Oh. So it's nice to be able to give something back.
Well,
I hope the campaign
that'll
works.
Be explained throughout the telecast. I only hold you up to all the boys. Have a great night, and Mark, have a great night. Thank you very much for coming. Yeah. And for you,
Molly, it's always been a thrill.
Same here, mate.
All right, cheers.
We'll get back in.
Voilà, le ciel est tout gris. Je ne sais pas combien de kilomètres je vais pouvoir marcher.
Thank you.
Vigne. Thank you.
Thank you.
Après 5 km et 53 minutes de marche, j'ai rejoint le Ravel à 4 km du centre de Nivelles.
Thank you.
une heure de marche et bientôt 6 km.
Thank you.
après 1h10 et 6 km 600 de marche, je retourne sur Nivelles.